Hello, Stu. Hello, viewers. I'm Dr. K. Sarojin Chakravarti, working as assistant professor in the Department of Botany, Government Degree College, Kaithavar, Hyderabad. In today's class or session, we are going to learn about an important topic of plant tissue culture, that is micropropagation. So, what is micropropagation? Micropropagation is the regeneration of whole plant through tissue culture technique. So what happens in this micropropagation? Callus mass has been initiated from an explant within a short time and space. Why micropropagation technique is very important? Because we can generate multiple plants within a short time and space and from a small living plant material, that is an explant. So in the last class, we have seen what is an explant. Now we'll see what is a callus. Callus is an unorganized mass of proliferating cells produced in culture or nature from an explant or a plant organ. So in this picture, very clearly you can see this is callus. So from where it has, you know, developed, it has developed. So this is nothing but proliferating, unorganized mass of proliferating cells. So they are not differentiated. But when you place this callus in a nutrient medium having an appropriate plant hormones, then it will get differentiated into root and shoot. So it will form a plantlet. So callus is an unorganized mass of proliferative cells produced in culture. So this is in culture or in nature from an explant or a plant organ. Okay, so through plant tissue culture techniques. So one of the techniques is micropropagation. So micropropagation is the rapid vegetative propagation of plants under in vitro conditions of high light intensity, controlled temperature and a defined nutrient medium. So here these, along with the explant, even these in vitro conditions, they play an important role. So you should have a proper light intensity, controlled temperature and the nutrient medium on which we are placing this explant, it plays an important role along with having in aseptic conditions. And it is possible to make a large number of callus pieces, that is callus pieces from the original stock culture during subculture. So how it is done is, so when you take this is a callus. So from this callus, if you place a piece of callus on to the nutrient medium or culture medium, that is known as subculturing. So it becomes the original stock. From this original stock, when you place a small piece of callus on an appropriate culture medium, it develops into plant. So like this, from this callus, we can produce large number of plantlets. Okay. So now we'll see what are the different stages of micropropagation. So the micropropagation is a complicated process and it involves 5 stages. Stage 0 is known as mother plant selection and growth. Stage 1 is initiation and establishment. Stage 2 is multiplication of shoots. Stage 3, rooting. Stage 4 is acclimatization or hardening. Now we'll see each stage in detail. Stage 0, that is mother plant selection and growth. So this is the initial step in micropropagation and it involves the selection and growth of stock plants for about 3 months under controlled conditions. So the second stage is initiation and establishment. So stage 1 is we have to select a plant from which we want to produce many plantlets. Okay, so that is one is selection. And next is taking an explant from the selected plant, make it to grow on a nutrient medium in aseptic condition, a growth chamber. So that is the growth. Next stage is initiation and establishment. In this stage, initiation establishment of a culture in a suitable medium are achieved. So selection of appropriate explants is important. Okay, And the chosen explant is to be surface sterilized, as we discussed how surface sterilization done in the next last class. That is, surface sterilization is done using different chemicals. One is a TPOL, another one is alcohol. Next one is 0.1% mercury chloride or 0.5% sodium hypochlorite or calcium hypochlorite. So that we have to do washing, proper washing and surface sterilization of the explant. That is very important. After that, the explant is placed on the appropriate nutrient medium. So like this. So in this picture, we are seeing an explant. So this is an explant of a leaf. Okay, so this is an explant of a leaf or a bud portion. So we have taken out the stem along with the bud portion and we have placed in an appropriate medium. So this is known as initiation and establishment. So here, what the type of explants we'll take? The most commonly used explants are organs. So any plant organ, shoot tips and axillary buds. The chosen explant, as I said, it should be surface sterilized and washed before use, because we should get rid of whatever microorganisms present on the explant. They should be cleaned. They should be sterilized. So as we discover, what are the explants? So here, this is the flower. In the flower, we can take anther as an explant, or we can take ovule or the ovary an explant. Okay, so these are the different explants of from a flower. That is, we can take an anther, or you can take the stamen, or we can take the ovary, or we can take the ovule. If you take an leaf also, so any part of the leaf, okay, any part of the leaf, it can be used as an explant. If you take a plant, if the terminal bud, any buds or flower, okay, leaf axil, okay, next nodal region, leaf blade, next even the root, even any part of the root, it, or any part of the stem, any bud, it may be the lateral bud or the terminal bud, axil and the terminal bud, or a flower portion, or leaf axil, or any leaf blade. Okay, so we can take all these organs or parts of a plant can be used as an explant in this micropropagation technique of tissue culture. Next, stage two. So what is stage two? Stage two is multiplication of shoots. So what we did, we have selected an explant, first plant. From that, we have taken an explant. As I said, any can be used as an explant. Then we have surface sterilized the explant. Now this explant is placed on a nutrient, appropriate nutrient medium, and allowed to grow. Now the explant, it undergoes totipotency. Okay, so you know what is totipotency, capability of multiplication of cell. So totipotency takes place, giving rise to callus. So callus, what is callus? Callus is an unorganized mass of proliferating cells. So if you subculture the callus onto a appropriate nutrient medium, you'll get number of plants. So after that, the second stage is multiplication of shoots. So in stage two, it involves multiplication of shoots or rapid embryo formation from the explant. So a growth chamber is set up at the temperature of 20 to 24 degrees centigrade, with 2000 to 4000 lux light intensity and a lighting period of 16 hours or so. So this is very important. These control conditions in culture room or growth room is very, very important for the initiation of multiplication of shoots. So the multiplication of shoots, it involves four methods. The first one is callus mediated multiplication. Second one is adventitious shoots mediated multiplication. Third one is by apical or axillary shoots. Last is direct or indirect embryogenesis. So whatever it may be the method, so it involves in the multiplication of shoots. So this is, this multiplication of shoots is done when an appropriate plant hormones are added to the culture medium on which we are placing the explant. So a high cytotoxin, cytokinin, that is plant hormone to auxin ratio, is used during the multiplication stage to induce axillary or adventitious shoot formation. So this, the second method, adventitious shoots mediated multiplication, it is done by adding a high amount of cytokinin to auxin. Then it induces axillary or adventitious shoot formation. So the second one is, if you want to have a high concentration of cytokinin, it also results in the high number of adventitious shoots, but that do not elongate. So cytokines what are used in this culture are benzyl adenine and kinetin. So this is in this picture, we can very clearly see there are multiple shoots. This is one shoot, another shoot, this third one. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So many shoots, so multiple shoots have it. So if you cut the one of the shoot in a laminar airflow, and if you subculture this into another nutrient medium, this will grow into a plantlet. This will grow into another plant. This one. So like this, from a single explant or as from a single cell, you can get multiple shoots through this micropropagation technique. Next, stage 3 is rooting. So we got the shoots. Now what we require is, we require root formation. Okay, so in this stage, it involves the transfer of shoots to a medium for rapid development of roots. Okay, so how it will take place? So so what happens to develop these roots? What we have to add in the medium is, we have to add auxins. So when we add auxins, it results in the formation of rooting. So like this. So we have taken a piece of a shoot from the multiple shoots. It has excised from that, and we have placed in subculture into another growth medium or nutrient medium, where you know auxin is in high concentration, which results in the formation of roots. So this is known as rooting. After rooting, the last stage in micropropagation is acclimatization or hardening. So in the last class, we have seen what is acclimatization. It means because till now, where it is growing, all these conditions will be, you know, it is going in a culture growth, means in a controlled conditions, controlled environmental conditions, that is in the growth room or a culture room. But when you place the same, this plantlet into a natural environment, it can't sustain itself in the natural environment, because till now the plantlet has grown in a growth condition, controlled growth condition. So what we have to do in the last stage is, we have to make this plantlet to get acclimatized or adjusted to the natural environment. So for that, what we have to do is, we have to establish these plantlets in the soil. First, we have to transfer them into small cups. Okay. Small culture cups where soil is present, and we have to place them it. And this tissue culture plants, they have to transfer them into these small cups containing soil. Okay, for survival of regenerative plants due to desiccation, infection, and light temperature shock. So that's why we have to place them, these plantlets are into a small cups, and we have to place them in these small cups containing the soil, transfer them immediately from the culture room to the growth room, and then transfer these, place them in the greenhouse. So in the greenhouse, we'll maintain the natural environmental conditions. So when you place them immediately in the plant, so we are making the regenerative plants to get survived from desiccation. You know what is desiccation? From infection of microorganisms, or we have to protect them from light temperature shock. So this is done by transferring the plantlets of stage 3 from the growth conditions or laboratory conditions to the environment of the greenhouse. So this is known as acclimatization. When you place them in the greenhouse, slowly the regenerated plants or plantlets will get adjusted or acclimatized to the natural conditions in the greenhouse. So now these acclimatized plants are then transferred to the field. So these are the different stages of micropropagation. So this is where we are placing them in a small plastic box or a cup, where we are having a soil. So this is known as acclimatization or hardening process. Now we are from the growth room, we are placing them in the natural greenhouse condition, then we'll transfer to the natural environmental conditions. So these are the, in a glimpse, we can see what are the different stages of micropropagation. The first one is, we have to select a plant, and we have to take a explant from this, any part of the plant which is used as a plant, a single plant cell. It is known as explant. So first is establishment of explants, that takes almost 2 to 3 months. Then Second stage is the initiation establishment, then shoot multiplication, and after that rooting. After rooting, then we have to go with the last stage, that is acclimatization. That is from greenhouse to, then we'll go with the natural environmental conditions. So this is the different stages of micro propagation. Now we'll see what are the types of micro propagation techniques. So there are three different types of micro propagation techniques based on the way of propagation we've done. The first one is the propagation from shoots with cytokinin like benzyl adenine or kinetin. The second type is multiple shoot differentiation from dedifferentiating tissue or callus or within an auxin like indole acetic acid, IAA. Or the third one is embryo differentiation from callus. So these are the three different types of techniques used in micropropagation. Now we'll see applications and advantages of micropropagation. So why micropropagation, you know, is advantageous? What application part it has? Okay, so the first one is plant tissue is in small amounts is sufficient for the production of millions of clones and plantlets in a year using micropropagation. Second one is it would take a great deal of time to produce an equal number of plants using conventional methods. That's why micropropagation is, you know, within a short time and space, we can produce millions of clones from a small plant tissue or a cell. That's why micropropagation is advantageous over conventional methods. Next, second one is it provides a good alternative for those plant species that show resistance to practices of conventional bulk propagation. And it is an alternative method of vegetative propagation for mass production. And it is, occurred through micropropagation. So plants in large numbers can be produced in a short period. Any plant particular variety may be produced in a large quantities, and the time to develop new varieties reduced by 50%. So time saving is there through micropropagation. And large amounts of plants can be maintained in small spaces. So there is no constraint of space also. This helps to save endangered species and the storage of germplasm. So this is very important. If any plant species is in the endangered condition, that plant species can be, can be saved through micropropagation technique, and germplasm can be stored. So this is another one. Next is micropropagation method. It produces plants which free of diseases. Okay. Next, increased yield of plants and increased vigor in floriculture species are achieved. Next, fast international exchange of plant material without the risk of disease introduction is provided. Means quarantine. When a plant has to be taken from one country to another country, one place to another place, then quarantine check is there. So if any plant is, having any kind of a microorganism disease, then the plant is not allowed to in that country. So that's why, to avoid all these things, micropropagation technique can be used where, instead of taking the plant, we can take the germplasm or the callus of the plant, where the callus is free of microorganisms, free of diseases, and that callus can be developed in that country where we want to have these plantlets. So like this, international exchange of plant material can be done without any risk of quarantine and the risk of introduction of any diseases through the plants where we are exchanging. So this is one good technique for that. And if the proliferation of in vitro stocks can be done at any time of the year. So especially in nursery, we can produce fruit, ornamental and tree species throughout the year. Next, another important is that micropropagation technique is also used for seed production in certain crops, as the requirement of genetic conservation to high degree is important for seed production. This micropropagation having various advantages over conventional methods of propagation. So this method, it holds better scope and future for the production of important plant-based phytopharmaceuticals. So this is another important application or advantages of micropropagation. Another one is independent of availability of plants, micropropagation offers a lucrative alternative approach to conventional methods in producing controlled amounts of biochemicals. Therefore, intense and continuous efforts in this field will direct controlled and successful production of valuable, specific, and undiscovered plant chemicals. So this is regarding in pharmaceuticals, phytopharmaceuticals, and biochemicals. Though they have advantages, okay, even you know, one more advantage is the microbial method, it produces plants free of diseases. Okay, so next, though they have advantages, even some limitations are there with this micropropagation technique. So what is the limitations or demerits of this micropropagation technique? Is micropropagation technique, it requires intensive labor, and this often limits their commercial application. And automation can reduce the labor required. So this is the only limitation with the micropropagation. Otherwise, this is one of the best technique used in plant tissue culture technique. So where within a short time and in a limited space, we can produce large number of plantlets from an explant, which given an explant or a desired plant. So that's why this micropropagation is an advantageous method over conventional methods in plant propagation. So this micropropagation is advantageous over vegetative propagation. In the next class, we'll see what another important technique of plant tissue culture. That is anther culture.